Peace, everybody. This is Queen Ifama. I am the Truth Terrorist. And today I'm doing a video on education because I've been thinking about it a lot. And I think that, you know, this whole education system is kind of messed up. Because, let me cut this down a bit. Because I'm going to tell you why. There is no way that your child should come out of school in debt. Okay? Not to mention the fact that these young people coming out of these colleges can barely find work. Okay? Comparable to what they, I saw some on the lens. Comparable to what they went to school for. You know, I think that from his concept, and we've, you know, touted education on, you got to get your education. But education is a business, just like every other fucking business in this country. It's to suck off the people that indulge in it or engage in it. And I think that the educational system has definitely sucked off the people, particularly young people. They will be in debt until they're in their 40s or 50s if they come out of school at 21? You understand? They come out thousands of dollars in debt, okay, because they have to take out loans in order to, you know, further their education. Not to mention that, why in the fuck does a damn book cost $100 and something, okay, that you only go use in one damn class? That should tell you something, okay? But nobody is railing against the educational system overall, and the educational system is sticking it to the people who are seeking education. We've just been sucking it up and going for it. But, you know, as I look at, I don't even have a degree. Okay, I tried to go to college. I just couldn't get with it. You know, everybody ain't college material. I'm not. But as a result, I'm $24,000 in debt, you know, to the Department of Education. Just trying to go to school. You understand? It took me like a few years to realize this ain't you. You ain't the education type. You're already smart. You don't need to go to school. You don't need a piece of paper for people to... so that people can know that you're smart. I realized that, you know, but I had got caught up in the hype of, you know, education and how valuable it is. And then I started looking at people who were educated and what they were going through, the financial problems that they were having as a result of them trying to get education. And I'm like, this is definitely not for me, even though I'm still in debt. Yeah, and Lord knows, they'll get it when I give it to them. It's been, how old I've been owing them for a few years now, and I ain't gave them nothing. I keep, you know, playing the system, but you can only play it so far, okay? I mean, where you keep putting it off, right? So eventually I'm gonna have to pay, but after a while I'll be a senior citizen for real on Social Security and can't pay it, okay? Then what they gonna do, all right? But anyway, my point is this. Is that we've not organized around the educational problem, because it is a problem, particularly our students who are striving and want to go to college. Okay, they get in college, they paying $100 for books, a book that they gonna take one fucking class with, try to sell a book back, don't get as much back for the book if they can sell a book back. All right, they taking these high astronomical courses. These credits per credit, some of these classes is $100 and something. My daughter paying out of pocket to go to college right now. You know, it's a lot of money. Okay, it's a money making industry, and it doesn't have to be that way when we look at examples of other countries where, you know, they provide education for their citizens because the citizens are going to use that education in the country. But no, the United States is not like that. I've seriously been thinking about trying to find someplace else to go outside of the U.S. And no, I ain't talking about goddamn Africa, okay? I'm not talking about Africa, all right? I'm looking for some place. I'm just ready to get out of here. And I don't think Africa is a place that my personality would be welcome in Africa. I don't think it would. Probably nowhere, actually. It ain't welcome here in the U.S. Just to put that on record. But, you know, you be trying to find a place to escape. I feel like a runaway slave. I want to get out of here. Oh, do you have this office? Oh, you have this right now? Oh, let me go. Okay, I'll be right back. Okay, I had almost got booted. I got booted out another room because they said that this room was taken, and well, come to find out, it's not taken. It was the meeting that they had in here was canceled. So excuse me. So I got an opportunity to use this room, which is my favorite room anyway. But anyway, back to my music, which, you know, I like Nairobi, Selah. But anyway, so I was just wondering why the public has allowed, and I guess it's because of the whole education. People seem to be intimidated by educate whores and people who are, you know, dealing with the educational realm to the point that they don't feel as though they can be, you know, challenged as to what they're doing. And I'm like, there is no way that young people coming out of college should be in debt. Not for the next 10 to 20 years of their damn lives paying off a student loan. Not only that, I don't think that this damn thing is too loud to, for even me to talk over. Cut it down a little bit. But this is cute though. I put this in my iPod and it got a little speaker on it. Ain't that cute? I like little novelty shit like this. But anyway, you know, I was thinking about that. I've been thinking about it, but this is the first time I've done a vlog on it. And the fact that, you know, you look at places like Cuba and other countries where education is free. You know, you could go to Cuba and become a doctor. I know a young lady here from, well, she was going there, and she went there like for the first 2 or 3 years to medical school over in Cuba, free. You know what I mean? So I don't know why the American people, so-called free people, have not challenged it. And like I said, I do kind of think I know why, and that's because we don't like to challenge educators because we think they're smarter than us. And I'm like, honey, look, I done ran into some dumbass people with degrees. Trust me, I work up in an industry that has a whole bunch of these degree-ass dummies, all right? You know, they pass tests. That's what they're good at. They're good at passing tests and writing essays and things like that, theses and things like that. But when it comes to common sense shit that makes sense, they ain't smart like that. You know, just to put that on record. You know, I got parents intimidated by principals and shit. I'm like, that motherfucker ain't no smarter than you, if you ask me. But a lot of times people are intimidated by people who sit behind desks. And I'm saying, don't be intimidated by those who sit behind desks, because you're in front of the desk and you're just as important. That's why I try to instruct people going on interviews and things, don't be nervous. You know, you got the skills. You have to show confidence sitting on the other side of that desk, because those on the other side of the desk think they got one up on you. But, you know, that's a whole nother subject. But what I'm talking about now is the educational system all over the country, and the fact that young people and people who aren't young that have to go into these colleges. You don't come from, you know, wealthy families who pay your tuition off the rip, you know, right out the door. They would plop down $10,000, $20,000, $25,000, $48,000 for tuition and buy all your damn books. And like I said, to me, I don't understand why some of these books are so damn expensive and you're only going to use them in one damn class. You know, I don't understand, how do we allow that to happen? And a lot of you are educated. I know you're educated. You may still be paying off student loans or putting it in deferment, like I am. Or putting them in deferment. You understand? Why do we have to do that? Why is American people always in debt? You know why? I'm going to tell you why. It's because you're slaves. You're slaves to this government, to this United States of America. Everybody in this bitch is a slave. I'm just going to put that on record that participates in any of his systems. I'm just going to put that on record. Okay, I'll be trying, like I told y'all on the onset, I'm trying to find a place to escape, to go to. But ain't no place to go. Ain't nowhere to run. It's like this everywhere, because I'm not going back to school. So, you know, education is what I'm talking about right now. But I'm talking about the whole system of human beings is the same, because various people have different psychologies. I mean, you have different natures. Like I talk about people's nature. They have different natures all over the world. So I could go to Africa. It wouldn't be no different. You understand? I wouldn't be treated better. You know what I'm saying? If people decide that they didn't like how I talked, how I walked, how I looked, or whatever. You understand? Because people develop their aversions, you know, and their prejudices, and there's no way to run. So, hey, I guess I was just, you know, speaking a pipe dream, because I'm not really going anywhere. I don't think there's really nowhere to go at my income level. Now, I could say if I had loot, if I had money, ain't no way in the hell I'd live here. Okay? Because money talk, baby. Bullshit walk all over the world. And if I had scratch, ain't no way in the hell I'd stay here. I'd be out of the, you know, I'd be a visitor. I'd come back to visit and go to the doctor. Because from what I understand, the best healthcare system is here, even though cost-wise, it's whacked. You know, because if you ain't got no money, you gonna get bad service. If you don't know how to speak up and you don't know how to do research on your own behalf, and you depending on some person in a white coat sitting behind a desk telling you what you need, yeah, they gonna tell you what you need so they can feel their buddy over there, feed their buddy over there, or go take this test from this buddy over here. I'm telling you, that's how that shit works. But back to the education thing. I don't know why we haven't raised our voices about that. Why we haven't raised our voices about the fact that our children come out of college in debt. Why should they? You understand? You acquire debt over, you know, when you come out of school and go to work and buy a house, buy a car, buy this, buy that. You acquire debt. You shouldn't come out of school, ain't even got a damn job, and your ass is in debt to the government. You should not have to do that. No. And I'm just saying, for those of you now who have children, maybe y'all should start organizing around that. You know, to really look at the education system and what it's actually doing. You understand? Because Lord knows, by the time you get to college, you're probably undereducated anyway, depending on where you come from. All right? Because, you know, they don't have equal education in this country. You know, it's all about the Benjamins. It's all about who got the snaps. It's all about who got the loot. You understand? You're paid. You look, let me tell you something. You get services based on your loot, baby. That's how it goes here. You know? And you can be smart as a whip. Now, you can go get you some grants, some, you know, what you call them? Not grants, but scholarships and things like that. That only go so far. That only goes so far, sweetheart. That's why you got a lot of them trying to go to school on basketball scholarships and shit like that, but then you got to take a whole bunch of shit. You understand? And you still, sometimes you still wind up, you know, taking out a loan for something. You understand? But my thing is, you got to buy the books. The books are so expensive. The classes are so expensive, you know? And I just be wondering, what are they paying these damn professors? You know, the people who stand in front of you and teach y'all, you know, what they're supposed to teach y'all. I wonder what are their salaries like, because I know they get pretty damn good money here in the public school system. I'm going to tell you, I've seen salaries, whoa, I'm telling you, like over $100,000, and I ain't talking about they ain't the superintendent either, okay? So, you know, this rant today, because this is a rant today. I'm just going to be honest with you. I am ranting because I'm frustrated at what I see. You know, and the fact that, you know, we're not raising our voices at something as simple as education, and why we protest every damn thing else, okay? And when education comes, we just want it to be equal, but we don't want it to be fair, and it's not fair. The educational system is not fair, okay? Not only is it unequal, it's not fair, you know, and for young people who get the scholarships, who get the grades and all that, to have to come out of college in debt, I got a big problem with that. Because I'm looking at my daughter struggling right now. You know, she wanted to go to graduate school. She owed one college $5,000, a school that she didn't go to, mind you, because she changed her mind, she withdrew. But she had took out a loan to get in the damn college, okay? So she owed them money. And now, because they won't release her transcript, she can't go to graduate school until she pay that money back. So now, she has to get two jobs. Thank God she ain't got kids or family and all that other kind of shit. You know, she definitely have to defer her damn dream of going to school to get her master's degree in physical therapy. You know? So I just think the whole system is fucked up. Really, I do. You know, and, you know, the fact that our young people have to go through this shit, you know, it's just sad to me. I don't know how y'all feel about it. But I know my friend Grace's son is in college. I think he's in college. And I know my friend Don's daughter, I think she's in college. And these are younger people. And I'm trying to think of someone else online that I know that have children in college. And I'm like, and children that's on their way, because we say education is the key. Get your education, get that sheepskin, baby, and you'll go far in this land. And I'm saying, that ain't necessarily so. Okay, it ain't necessarily so. Like I'm not college material. Okay, I'm not sitting in a room listening to a motherfucker talk trying to tell me something. I'm not like that. I'm a get on the YouTube, Google some information shit type of chick. You know what I mean? That's how I learn. I learn through listening, and I learn through looking through information and finding it myself. I don't want no professor standing up in front of me, and whether he liked me or not, regardless of to the quality of my work, may be how he grades me. Okay? So I didn't want to keep or feel as though I was going to subject myself to some shit like that. So I decided after the last stint, and this was like in early 90s, that I tried to go back to school because education was so important. And you need a degree so you can move ahead in life. And I'm like, today, from where I sit right now, I don't need that. Because I think I'm where I'm supposed to be in life. You know, everybody have their places. And I'm in my place. And I'm comfortable in my place. You understand? I ain't trying to get higher and higher and higher and be like somebody else. I'm not trying to do that. I just want to stay on my square, be able to have three squares, three hots in a cot, as they call it, you know, and be able to do the things that I like and pay for the things that I like. And that's exactly what I do right now. But for those who aspire for higher education, you know, I just feel so sorry for you, because at the end of the day, you know, you are getting jacked at the end of the day trying to go the higher education route. I feel sorry for you. But there, you know, some, I guess you got to do what you got to do. But like I'm saying, there's power in the people. If the people organize and say, hell no, we ain't getting ready to keep paying all these high-ass prices for college. And we are not going to encourage our children to go. Because when they come out there in debt and they can't find a damn job to sustain them, you know, and they got to still stay with me. That's what y'all should tell them. Say, that shit ain't working out so good. You understand what I'm saying? But anyway, I just wanted to do this little rant because I've been thinking about it for a couple of days. And I said to myself, I was just sitting in my office thinking, I'm going to do a video about education, because I think education is whacked. The system of education is whacked. Not education in itself or learning in itself, but the system itself is whacked. How it's set up is whacked. Okay? It's designed for you to fail, basically. At the end of the day, whenever you come up out of that shit, it's really designed for you to fail. You gotta really put your boots on when you come out of college to be able to wade through the shit. Okay? Because you already come out with a sack on your back full of rocks, you know, of debt that you owe to the federal government. See, the federal government try to keep you on at some shape, in some shape, form, or fashion. Okay? And a lot of y'all want to blame it on the people on welfare, blame it on the people getting Social Security, insurance, and all that bullshit. No, it's not. Why come all you people out there complaining about that, why come you ain't saying nothing about the educational system? You just roll over and take that shit, right? Many of you who've been through the system, then seen your family members go through the system and come out in debt. You got 20, 30 years of debt. You paying off some goddamn student loans. I'm telling you, or working two and three jobs to pay tuition and shit like that. I mean, it's just sad. And it doesn't have to be like that, is what I'm saying. It doesn't have to be like that. So anyway, y'all, I appreciate you listening because I was really feeling this rant today. But I'm glad that, you know, I have this venue to be able to rant on. And because talking to these people, you know, they look at you, they got a blank face. They got blank, you know, because they don't get it. You know, they had never thought about it. Why do I have to pay all this money? Why is the system set up like this? What can be done to change it? They don't have these discussions on college campuses. I'm gonna put that on record. I have not heard not one person tell me that they talked about this type of shit on the college campus. Cause you in the house are the very people that's putting the screws to your ass. They ain't gonna talk, they ain't gonna have no conversations like that. You gotta do that organizing off campus, baby. Okay, talk about it over the lunch table and organize it off campus. Because they're you feeding all them people up in there. Okay, and the U.S. government too, government of education too. So anyway, I just had to talk about it because it was bothering me. And I appreciate you listening again. Thanks a lot, and I'll talk to y'all later. Have a good one. I got 2 days off, man. I'm happy. See ya. Okay, I had almost got booed.